is Vince Rosalia. I'm a senior solutions engineer with BMC. This video is part one of two on how to build reports and charts in smart reporting. In part one, we'll talk about building reports, and in part two, we'll discuss how to add charts to them. I'll dive right in and start creating a report. There are a number of different categories depending on your level of access. In this example, I'll create a report for incidents. Now let's start by selecting our fields. I want to see the number of incidents for each business service, and I also want to see the impact of those incidents and the status they're currently in. To find a field, I can browse through the folder structure, but it's very easy to search for the field I'm looking for. As we add fields to the report, we see it building instantly. And you know what? I don't like how this looks, so let's make some adjustments by dragging around columns and rearranging them how I want. Okay, it's looking a little bit better, but it's still a little crowded with some information that I'd like to filter out. I'm really only concerned with open tickets for this report, so let's filter the status. The report users probably don't need to see all the business services at one time, so let's give them the option to filter on that too. And they'll probably want to be able to select a range of dates, so let's add a filter for a submit date. Now that we have all of our filters selected, we can edit them to do what we want. We only want to see open tickets, so let's create a filter on status that only shows tickets that are less than closed. We can also see the default settings for the other filters. If we look at the filter logic below, we can see that they are set by default to prompt the user. When the report is run, the user will be prompted for the values that he or she would like to enter. Let's leave it like that. When we close out of the filter settings, we see the report is refreshed and only open records are showing. When we run the report in part 2, we will be prompted for the dates and the business service filters. We now have a basic report set up. Please join me in part 2, where we will add some charts to the report and put it all together. See you in part 2!